waxaan isu soo taagay fariinta koowaad ee la weydiiyey waxay ahayd ummadeennu waanay ku xidhan tahay taas waxaynu ka tallaabaynaa oo caan ahaa oo aan qarsoonayn inay nahay ummad hadasho uun oral society waxaynu u gudbaynaa oo aynu ku qasbannahay inaynu u gudubno oo ma sharxayo sababtaynu ugu qasbannahay inaynu u gudubno halkii adduunyadu gaadhay oo aynu waxeena qoranno si ay u badbaadaan markaan afeeftaydii ahaa waxaan lahaa waa la yidhi ilaahay raalliha ka noqdo cimrigana ha u dheereeyo caafimaadna ha siiye eh hadraawi iyo inta la midihi waxaa xigmadda ay yidhaahdeen haddii maanta aynu qori weyno meel dhigi weyno taasi way ina daynaysaa awaalo weynoo xasuusan doonaa cid kalena way xasuusan doontaa yaxiye bashuu xasuusan doonaa laakiin generationka saddexaad waa hubaal inay lumayso waxay la mid tahay fariintii halkan huda ay kaga hadlaysay sawirkii reebayay wixii halkaa yeelay wuu lumi doonaa waxaan isweydiiyey markaa maadaama la weydiiyey bandhiga caalamiga ee bugaagta Hargeysa oo wax ummaddan iska leedahay oo ku soo biirtay ummadda oo ay u keentay inay halkan gurigeeda ku samaysato maxaa kaa soo maray maxay ku timi maxaase kugu kalifay waxa aan sheegayaa wixii aan odhan lahaa inay halkan ka muuqdeen sawirkaasi wuu lumi doonaa gabaygaasi wuu lumi doonaa taariikhda ummaddani way lumi doontaa waxa ay jiritaankeedu yahay wuu lumi doonaa haddaynu waxaynu leenahay meel dhigan weyno oo aynu weel u samaysan weyno oo waxaynu leenahay ugu samaysan weyno oo si aynu leenahay ugu samaysan weydo inay lumi doonto baa xaqiiqa marka waxaad moodaa caawa inay isugu kay wada xidhan tahay mawduucii koowaad ee ahayd inaan ka bilaabo hadalkayga ee ahaa haddaynu ka gudbaynaynu ka tallaabayno ummadda afka qalaad lagu yidhaahdo oral society oo aynu u gudbayno waxa la yidhaahdo ummadda wixeeda qoratay maxaynu luminaynaa wax fara badan oo qurux badan baynu luminaynaa maxaysan isu helaynaa inoo badbaadaya innaga oo dhan baa lumi doonaa haddii aynu waxaynu qoran weynaynu ka gudbi weyno taa innaga oo dhan baa lumi doonaa haddii waxaynu nahay la inoo sheego cid kale inoo sheegto meel inoo dhigto oo aynu innaga dhigan weyno fariintu waxay tahay qolada innaga maqanaanu dirayaa maalintii book fair ku bilaabmayay waxaan la fadhiistay waxay ahayd 10 sano ka hor waxaan la fadhiistay qof imika dadka ugu waaweyn ee ahaa institution ahaan caawiya bandhiga caalamiga ee bugaagta Hargeysa wuxuu igu yidhi dadkaad sheegaysaa ead leedahay book ban kala hadlayaa waa dad illitay ereygii ingiriis dhahaa isticmaalay baan halkan ugu celinayaa u sheegaya waxay tidhi you are talking about the access to the culture and literature and your illiterate people are dying for hungry and thirst it would be good if you want to help your people to go to the international community and to ask food for them it would be good if you go back to the international community and ask to dig but forget about reading and writing culture I didn't agree of course so many other people for that reason I'm speaking in English and switching from one to one because if I want that this message goes to that people after 10 years this thing is changing Someone said that in any case these people would not have been any case by habit to read books so forget about it what you are doing change the program and select one something else it was in 2008 we chose a theme and it was governimo and I'm so happy that tonight we are here and talking about Gul iyo Gubanimo. It was late July. We were in the city. We started with a long weekend. We get more or less 200 people who came to visit us. And we had nothing to be international, but we claimed it to be the TEDxHargeisa International Book Fair. Since then, of course, the book fair luckily grew up because of these people, because of Somaliland, because of those people who believed it and who invested in and who explained it to the other people that we can do by ourselves and we can choose what we want. Yes, of course, we had a huge amount of problems. Yes, the hunger was there. But this society needed to change by itself. This society needed to change and explain to the world that it can be another face of the so-called Somali people. When you heard, I was in Europe, and when you heard the word Somali, before you go to Somaliland, Somalia, and somewhere else, what comes to your mind and what the journalists want to say is that there is a hunger, there is Al-Shabaab, there is a piracy, there is so many bad things that has to do, unfortunately, with the word Somali. We wanted to give something different. We wanted to give another message to the world. And these people were proved wrong. Because of people in Somaliland love reading. Because of young Somalilanders were described as a hunger for books. And because that of that reason, in everywhere now, anyone is speaking about the book fair and how it's important and how it was important to have a book fair. But where is the secret? I think the secret is the people of Somaliland. Because of this society, the word I would love to explain in Somali deeply is resilience. Dr. Bilhan explained the art of survival. This society built its foundation because of what it has, not because of what it gets from outside. And that is the base of our institutions, and that's the base of our existence, and that's the base of the message that today we want to give from here. Somaliland stands on what it owns. Somaliland stands for its poetic. Somaliland stands for its young people. This generation of Somalilanders were born only within Somaliland. They had no any other option, any other thought, except because of their Somalilanders. And that's where it's coming, the force of this country. So the message that we were giving within the book fair exactly goes in that way, and exactly it worked, and that is what we are proud of the book fair. Just I list here some of how we started. In 2008, we started to talk about freedom and censorship, citizenship, collective memory, visualizing the future, journey. Then we started with the imagination, leadership, creativity, which was the last year. You feel that all these teams are connected each other, and they have only one message. That message is that this society decided to move. Even though we know that what we are losing from the orality that we have and moving to the written culture, but we decided, and as a society we want to move, and this connectivity helped us to make what Somaliland is today. The resilience of this society is coming from this young generation who want to give that message to the world. That goes beyond what we have in the Horn of Africa. Now, if you reflect on the themes that we selected this year, we need the thing that we were talking about initially, being a link in the art of survival, the art of society, but it is own as a society, not only individuals. The art of resilience, or what we can say, the message that we gave from our Asian people who want to preserve what they gave us as a knowledge production, is the only way that we can bring here is about moving from orality to the written culture. And that is what we want to underline one more time and explain, that if this generation want to make with their own what we have built on their previous generations, is the fact that it should be recorded and postponed and sent to the next generations. So how we can do? How we can have the concept of Hadrawi and don't lose the knowledge that we produced for centuries and centuries, but we have to make in a way that we can pass to the next generation and build the knowledge that we have today. Where is the connection? The connection is our culture, our art, our music, our wisdom will not survive if we still maintain what the other societies already passed and failed on it, which is the pure orality of the thing. Huda explained it well and pictured and made a photo of what I am talking about. If our literature, if our history, if our wisdom remains only in words, words are forgotten. Words should be put and stopped and make a picture on every aspect of this society. And that is the force of the written word. Where is the next? What is the secret of this code of written culture? The secret is that if you copy and make a copy paste and take from the other people, then you will fail, because you will feel you will lose what you produced, what you owned, and what you were being known. The secret is that we have to work ethnomathematics, but we have to work of what we produce by ourselves, by our knowledge, in the medium that the people who won with the nature use it, the written culture. The move to the written culture is the thing that is saving us while we have in mind, when we have in mind that we are coming from a society that existed, that produced knowledge, that has its own history, and that has its knowledge production with its own resources. To the person to whom I had this message, which I met 11 years ago, I say, yes, we need army, we need peace, we need infrastructure, we need roads, we need institutions that are working, but also we need art and culture, and have the right for our young generation to have access to that rights of art and culture and literature that they own. Because of that message, it comes from the fact that art makes the human humane. Thank you.